Now coming to next topic, that is TE mode of propagation in circular waveguide. As I have said, single conductor transmission line supports either TE mode of propagation or TM mode of propagation, but it doesn't support TEM mode of propagation. I have proved that statement also on the rectangular waveguide. Here also I will prove that statement that circular waveguide doesn't support TEM mode of propagation, right? Now coming to first, we have seen three different types of modes of propagation, that is TE mode of propagation, that is transverse electric mode, and TM mode of propagation, transverse magnetic mode, and another one is transverse electromagnetic mode of propagation, that is TEM mode, right? We have hybrid mode also, but these three modes are important, right? Now coming to TE mode of propagation in circular waveguide, right? Here, now coming to this TE mode of propagation, see, transverse electric mode, right? Now what is the definition of TE mode? The electric field is purely transverse to the direction of propagation of wave. That means you won't find any electric field component. If I consider Z as direction of propagation of wave, you won't find any electric field component along Z axis, but you will find magnetic field component along Z axis, right? Transverse electric mode, which indicates that electric field is purely transverse to the direction of propagation of wave. Now from its definition, we know that Ez equals to 0 and Hz is not equals to 0. Now what will be the wave equation? Del square Hz, which is equals to minus omega square mu epsilon Hz, right? The same thing we have done under rectangular waveguide, only the difference is those are in terms of rectangular coordinates, but here you will have in terms of circular coordinates, right? Now from TE mode of propagation definition, you know that Ez equals to 0, Hz not equals to 0. Now the wave equation will be del square Hz, which is equals to minus omega square mu epsilon Hz, right? Now expanding this del square Hz in cylindrical coordinates, there you have expanded in rectangular coordinate, that is x, y and z, but here you have to expand in cylindrical coordinate, except that everything is same. Now expand del square Hz in cylindrical coordinates. Now here you will get dou square Hz by dou rho square plus 1 by rho dou Hz by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square Hz by dou phi square plus dou square Hz by dou z square, which is equals to minus omega square mu epsilon Hz, right? Now expanding del square Hz in cylindrical coordinate, that is dou square Hz by dou rho square plus 1 by rho dou Hz by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square Hz by dou phi square plus dou square Hz by dou z square, which is equals to minus omega square mu epsilon Hz, right? Now we know that dou square by dou z square, which is nothing but gamma square, right? Dou square by dou z square, which is nothing but gamma square. Now substitute that. Now here you will get dou square Hz by dou rho square plus 1 by rho dou Hz by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square Hz by dou phi square, right, plus gamma square. Now bring this to this side. I have represented dou square by dou z square as gamma square, and bring this to this side, and here you will get plus omega square mu epsilon Hz, which is equals to 0. This is nothing but gamma square. Here you will get gamma square Hz. Now bring this to this side, finally you will get this. Now gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon, which is nothing but h square, right? Now finally you will get expression as dou square Hz by dou rho square plus 1 by rho dou Hz by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square Hz by dou phi square plus h square Hz, which is equals to 0. Right. Now what is next step? Consider Hz equals to PQ, right? The same thing which we have done under rectangular waveguide. Now P is purely function of row only, and q is purely function of phi only. And a rectangular waveguide, we have considered pq only, but p is purely function of x and q is purely function of y. There is in terms of rectangular coordinates, and here it is in terms of circular coordinate. Now consider hz equals to pq, where p is purely function of rho only and q is purely function of phi only. Now substitute hz equals to pq in this equation, right? Now after substitute hz equals to pq, now here you will get dou square hz by dou rho square plus 1 by rho dou hz by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square hz by dou phi square plus h square hz equals to 0. Now substitute hz equals to pq, right? Now dou square by dou rho square of pq plus 1 by rho of dou by dou rho of pq. Directly I am substituting hz equals to pq plus 1 by rho square by dou phi square of pq plus h square of pq, which is equals to 0, right? Now p is purely function of rho and q is purely function of phi, right? Now this is derivative is in terms of rho, that's why you'll get q out, because it is purely function of phi independent of rho. Now here you will get dou square p by dou rho square. Now the same thing, q is out because it is independent of rho. Now q by rho dou p by dou rho, and here you will get p by rho square because p is purely function of rho, which is independent of phi, right? And here you will get dou square q by dou phi square plus h square of pq, which is equals to 0, right? Now what is next step? Dividing by pq on both sides. Dividing by pq on both sides. Now if I divide by pq on both sides, what you will get? 1 by p dou square p by dou rho square plus 1 by p into rho dou p by dou rho plus 1 by q into rho square dou square q by dou phi square plus h square, which is equals to 0, right? After dividing by pq on both sides, this is the expression that you are getting, right? And this expression we have to convert into nth order Bessel function, right? What is nth order Bessel function? That I will say after conversion, right? Now we have to do slight modification, that is multiplying by something, dividing by something, in order to convert this expression into nth order Bessel function. Till here, whatever we have done under rectangular waveguide, the same procedure is followed here. Now this expression you have to convert into nth order Bessel function. In order to find out the solution, you have to do some modification. Now that modification starts from here, right? Now multiplying by rho square on both sides, right? Now if I multiply by rho square on both sides, what you will get? Rho square by p, right? Rho square by p dou square p by dou rho square plus, now here you have one rho term, right? Here you will get rho by p dou p by dou rho plus 1 by q dou square q by dou phi square plus h square rho square, which is equals to 0, right? After multiplying by rho square on both sides, you will get this expression. Now represent this 1 by q dou square q by dou phi square as minus n square, right? You are doing slight modification in order to convert to nth order Bessel function. What it is, I will say it next, right? Now represent this 1 by q dou square q by dou phi square as n square, right? Now finally you will get rho square by p into dou square p by dou phi square plus rho by p dou p by dou rho right, rho by p dou p by dou rho. Now this is nothing but n square, right, plus h square rho square minus n square. This thing I am representing here, which is equals to 0, right. Now to this expression, multiplying by p on both sides, multiplying by p on both sides, multiplying by p on both sides, right. Now after multiplication I am writing final expression, right. Now we have rho square by p dou square p by dou rho square, right, dou square p by dou rho square plus gamma rho by p dou square dou p by dou rho dou p by dou rho plus h square rho square minus n square plus h square rho square minus n square. This is equals to 0. Now to this expression, multiply by p on both sides. If I multiply by p on both sides, you will get rho square by dou square p dou rho square plus rho into dou p by dou rho plus h square rho square minus n square of p, which is equals to 0, which is equals to 0, right, which is equals to 0. Right. Now this is your nth order Bessel function, right. Now this is your nth order Bessel function. Now I am writing nth order Bessel function. Now that is given by x square dou square y by dou x square plus x into dou y by dou x plus x square minus n square into y, which is equals to 0, right, which is equals to 0. Now if I compare this with this expression, slight modification has to be done. See here, x is nothing but rho h, right. Now I am slight modification, that is rho h square dou square p by dou of rho h square plus rho h of dou p by dou of rho h plus rho h square whole square minus n square p, which is equals to 0, right. Now this we have converted into nth order Bessel function, right. Now to this Bessel function, this is equals to 0, you will have its solution. Now for this nth order Bessel function, solution is given by y is equals to cn of jn of x, right. You will have Bessel roots, right. This you will come under numerical methods. In mathematics you will get this thing, Bessel function. Just remember nth order Bessel function. You are converting TE mode of propagation wave equation into nth order Bessel function and you are finding its solution. Now we have converted this wave equation into nth order Bessel function. Now if you compare these two, now what is y? Y is nothing but p, right. If you compare these two equation, if you compare these two equation, y is nothing but p. Now x is nothing but rho h, x is nothing but rho h, y is nothing but p. Now what is the solution of this wave equation? See, for this particular nth order Bessel function, solution is y equals to cn of, where cn is constant, right. Now jn of x is nothing but you will get roots, Bessel roots, right. You will get Bessel roots, that is n is varying from 1, 2, 3, so on, right. Now x value is nothing but rho h, right. Now what is the solution of this wave equation? Now what, y, for this nth order Bessel function, solution is y equals to cn of jn of x. Now we have converted this wave equation into nth order Bessel function. Now what is the solution you will get? Now what is the value of y? If you compare y, you are getting it as p. Now constant will remain same, cn of j naught and x is nothing but rho h, right? Now we are getting p, right? We have considered hz equals to pq, right? We have considered hz equals to pq. Now we know p is purely function of rho. If you see this equation, it is purely function of rho only, right? Where q is purely function of phi. Now we have found out p. Now what is q? Q is nothing but the same thing, an cos n phi, right? An cos n phi plus bn sin n phi, right? We have found out p, that is cn into jn of rho h, and q is purely function of phi, that is an into cos n phi plus bn sin n phi. Now using this p and q, we have to find out field component hz, right? Now we have considered hz equals to pq, right? Now what is p? We got it after converting into nth order Bessel function, and its solution will be p equals to cn into jn of rho h, right? Now what is q? It is purely function of phi, right? It is purely function of phi, that is given by an cos n phi plus bn sin n phi, right? Now what is its general solution, right? And general solution will be under root of an square plus bn square plus into cos n phi plus tan inverse of cos n phi plus theta. Theta is nothing but tan inverse of b by a, right? And here you will get it as an by bn, right? Now hz, which is nothing but pq, right? Now substitute those values, hz, which is equals to, now what is p? Cn into jn of rho h. Now q is nothing but an cos n phi plus bn sin n phi, and its general solution will be under root of an square plus bn square into cos of n phi plus tan inverse of an by bn, right? Now this you will get constant, right? That constant I am representing it as cn cap, right? That constant I am representing it as cn cap, and this total thing I am representing it as n phi, right? Now finally you will get hz equals to cn into cn cap, it is also constant, into jn of rho h into cos n phi, right? Now these two constant together I am representing it as a single constant, that is c naught. Now what you will get finally, hz equals to c naught of jn of rho h into cos n phi. Now this is the field component in TE mode of propagation. Now anyhow you know Ez equals to 0. Now the remaining field components you have to find out, E rho, E phi, H rho and H phi, right? Now coming to remaining field components under TE mode of propagation, we have derived in previous lecture E rho field component, right? Now the E rho field component, now that is given by minus j omega mu by rho h square dou h z by dou phi minus gamma by h square dou e z by dou rho, right? Now this field component we have derived in previous lecture. Now we have to find out E rho field component under TE mode of propagation. Under TE mode of propagation you know that Ez equals to 0, right? Now E rho, which is equals to minus j omega mu by rho h square dou by dou phi of hz. Now what is hz? C naught into jn of rho h into cos n phi, right? Now expand, that is find out derivative of this equation. Now what you'll get finally, now E rho, which is equals to minus j omega mu by rho h square, now c naught into jn of rho h, since it is independent of phi, into minus n sin n phi, right? Into e power minus gamma z, because direction of propagation of wave along z axis, right? Now what you'll get finally, E rho equals to j omega mu by rho h square into c naught into n into j n of rho h into sine n phi into e power minus gamma z. Now this is the field component E rho and the TE mode of propagation. Now similarly you have to find out E phi. Now we know E phi, that is minus gamma by rho h square dou E z by dou phi plus j omega mu by h square dou h z by dou rho, right? Now this field component also we have derived in the previous lecture, right? Now we know for TE mode of propagation E z is 0, thus this total term will become 0. Now what you will get, E phi, that is equals to j omega mu by h square dou by dou rho of h z is c naught into j n of rho h into cos n phi, right? Now derivative of h z with respect to rho, now E phi, that is equals to j omega mu by h square, c naught is constant which is independent of rho, right? Now cos n phi is also independent of rho. Now dou by dou rho of j n of rho h, it is a solution, we don't know, see n is varying from 1, 2, 3, so on, we don't know which root it is. If I find out derivative, we can't say what is the exact value. That's why I am representing it as j n cap of rho h, right? Derivative of j n of rho h, which is nothing but j n dash of rho h, because we don't know n value. If I know n value, I can solve that equation. Because I don't know n value, I can consider it as j n dash of rho h, right? Now this is the field component of E phi, right? Now similarly we have to find out field component of h rho and h phi, right? Now what is h rho, field component of h rho? Now the field component of h rho, that is minus gamma by h square dou h z by dou rho plus j omega epsilon by rho h square dou e z by dou rho, dou phi, right? This field component we have derived under previous lecture, right? Now for TE mode of propagation E z is 0, this total term will become 0. Now E h rho equals to minus gamma by h square dou by dou rho of field component is h z that we have derived, that is c naught into j n of rho h into cos n phi, right? Now finally you will get h rho equals to minus gamma by h square c naught into j n dash of rho h into cos n phi into e power minus gamma z, which indicate direction of propagation of wave along z axis, right? Now similarly last field component, that is h phi. Now what is h phi field component? That is minus gamma by rho h square dou h z by dou phi, dou h z by dou phi minus j omega epsilon by h square dou e z by dou rho, right? Now we know e z equals to 0 for TE mode of propagation, this total term will become 0. Now what you will get, h phi equals to minus gamma by rho h square dou by dou phi of what is field component h z, c naught into j n of rho h into cos n phi, right? Now this is the field component. Now you have to find out derivative with respect to phi. You'll get h phi, that is minus gamma by rho h square c naught into j n of rho h into minus n sine n phi into e power minus gamma z. Now the final expression is h phi minus minus, you'll get plus, that is gamma by rho h square into c naught into n into j n of rho h into sine n phi into e power minus gamma z, right? Now these are the field components, H rho, H phi, E rho, E phi, and E z, H z, right? Now these are the field components under TE mode of propagation, right? Just derivation, there you have done under a rectangular waveguide. There you have done with respect to rectangular coordinates, but here you are doing with respect to circular coordinate. Now this is about TE mode of propagation, field components under TE mode of propagation in circular waveguide.